So, inevitably, I bring myself to talking about the newest and hottest shit on the online streaming block. In a rare twist of Netflix's release schedule, or common if you take Devilman Crybaby into account, Be the Beginning is Netflix's new foray into original anime content, and with it helming character designer Kazuto Nazukawa, an animation madman known for working on Sakamichi no Apollon and Shanplu, and Yoshiki Yamakawa, director of Little Busters, and a pretty intense concept and trailer, I know I, at least, was expecting the anime equivalent of smashing that nut button. However, interestingly, I'm seeing the dreaded 50-50 split on critics' consensus that's indicative of the Vietnam minefield of the current anime metagame. Say the wrong thing about this show and you're sure to end up missing a few limbs, and your childhood innocence. But besides that, let's go plot hunting. Kisu Frick is a detective who returns to the force after a serial killer employs some dudes to kidnap and presumably bad touch slash stranger in danger a young lady. Except they all died. Some other dude left a big old B and some tally marks at the crime scene and took all the credit. We're also introduced to Blandy McNaught, the main character, Kuko, and his lady friend Lily, who is an officer on the force with Keith. While getting the rundown on the case, Keith takes notice of her slightly uncomfortably, and the shit starts hitting the fan when a tank gets commandeered by the baddies, who look like they're straight from the Cirque du Soleil Bowie tribute. Intrigue, 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 plot, 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 and then here, at the episode 1 end credits is where I think things went a little haywire. Now, listen, before I go too heavily into what B does wrong, I need to emphasize that I think B is pretty good. Not the greatest show ever, but it does its job pretty well. Now that that's over with, let's talk about the issues. Spoilers, people. Spoilers abound. Be the Beginning takes a really hard left right out of the gate. So, let it be known, I love mysteries, and what it felt like they were setting up here was a mystery. But very quickly I realized that B was working in a lot of fantasy elements that really turned me off from the story. Don't get me wrong, the weird mystical shit they added in allowed for some of the coolest fight animation and composition we've seen in a while, but it felt really out of place to me. Everything about B was telling me that it was a mystery grounded more in reality, but what we ended up getting was Cowboy Bebop in the Shell's Pro Skater 2, which was not bad, not bad. In fact, it was incredibly impressive. I guess for me, it just came off as disappointing? No, confusing? No, unnecessary? It's like I walked into an ice cream shop to get what I'm hoping is a killer milkshake, but they're also like, hey, we've got some bomb-ass chicken wings, here you go. And I'm like, this is not at all what I expected, but damn, these are actually pretty good, but now I feel very sick due to protein and dairy overdose, and why am I doing so many food analogies recently? See, this is the other problem for me, because mysteries typically reflect their setting and use it to enforce the rules of their investigation, to a degree. If your mystery is grounded in reality, you use reality to its fullest extent and reasoning to do so. If the setting is fantasy, you do the same, but unfortunately, something you will run into is overcomplication. Too many story elements causing the viewer to suspend disbelief will also warp their grasp on the world you're building. I'm not making jokes, hang on. The bad guys look like they're drinking piss. Another problem that B has is info dumping. Mysteries typically do this, but in a more subtle way, allowing the viewer to piece things together on their own to a certain extent. But unfortunately, about halfway through the series, Keith just drops trow and unleashes a torrent of exposition like a trip to this world's version of a mystical Taco Bell. In this world, presumably, it's still got the Pizza Hut menu. Then, suddenly, all of this background exposition takes the forefront for the rest of the story, and the mystery aspect takes a bit of a backseat to this weird mystical intrigue that's practically spelled out for you by their mythology. Then, when the mystery's reveal is spelled out for you and Dr. McChainsmoke is actually the bad guy, it kind of feels like I saw it coming from a few miles away. Like, through the Hubble fucking telescope. Then, they have the audacity to commit one of my cardinal gunpoint standoff sins. Now that we're standing at gunpoint, and you know I've killed a few people, like possibly more than 30, you have no choice but to shoot me. You're under arrest. I would be, but you need to shoot me before I shoot the first person to walk through that doorway. Presumably the girl that reminds you of your dead sister. Oh no, instead of shooting around quickly at your arm and forcing you to lower your guard temporarily or even dropping your firearm, then charging you to take you down to the floor where I could then forcibly cuff you with my backup and take you in, I guess I'll just have to shoot you in the head. Seems like the reasonable option, I guess. But during all of this, our edgelord boy toy is fighting for his cookie-cutter girlfriend with his cookie-cutter villain in their already cookie-cutter mythos-driven ceremonial bout to decide who's the edgiest. And then they use a twist in this fight that was laid out in episode 3 or 4. I don't remember which one it was. So yeah, simplistically convoluted is a word combo that I would use here. I may sound salty, but that was just the issues that I had with the plot writing. They do end up revealing something after the credits that does make me interested in a season 2, and though I was drawn away from the plot, they do manage to wrap things up nicely in the end. The big thing is, though, after all of this bad shit, in terms of presentation, B takes the fucking cake in both atmosphere and style. From the esoteric OST OST to the over-the-top fight scenes and even down to the details in direction, B actually succeeds as an interesting art piece that does draw you in, at least from the outset. So in summation, I had a lot of problems with B the Beginning, but it does end up providing a solid concept at the end, albeit for a completely different kind of story than what was expected from me. I feel like I missed a joke. God damn it, I could have made a pee is stored in the balls joke.
I'm at the Pizza Hut.
What?
I'm at the Taco Bell.
What?
I'm at the combination Pizza Hut and Taco Bell.
I'm at the Pizza Hut.
What?
I'm at the Taco Bell.
Nah.
I'm at the combination Pizza Hut and Taco Bell.
Wait.